Hi, this is Jeremy from Dust3D. Dust3D is a free open source 3D modeling software for quick making game assets with texture and rig automatically generated. It supports Linux, macOS, and Windows. I usually post one video per week to share the progress of the development on this 3D modeling software and the news related. Okay, let's see what happened during the last week. First, deforming map. This is a new feature which allows you to specify an image to deform the generated mesh, and it is an experiment for preparing the sculpting feature. The result is quite good. Currently, the problem of the generated model from Dust3D is kind of lack variations. This will add more variations to the generation. Next, Jimmy reported an install issue on the latest macOS, and he have helped to test a workaround for running Dust3D on this system. Please check the install page for details. By the way, I started this 3D modeling software at the end of 2016 because of a blog post made by Jimmy. You can find the blog post link on the acknowledgements page of the software. I also linked the post in the description. It's a very inspiring post. I highly recommend to read it. Jimmy also gave many invaluable suggestions, such as the whole modeling scaling and the hotkey to select, or these features will be implemented in the future. His tweet is worth to follow. He shared many interesting tweets on 3D modeling. Please check his tweet link in the description. Next, I've set up a chat room, Discord chat room. Currently, only Satish and I joined. Thanks, Satish. I linked Satish's Twitter in the description. You can check the chat icon in the GitHub page to join. Please feel free to share your screenshot or talk anything related with 3D modeling. Next, the week before last week, I made many chair mods and I was really got tired of making chair anymore. But David suggested a toilet mod. I thought the toilet is definitely not a chair, so I just made it. He also shared many technical stuff on Twitter about 3D. Please check his Twitter link, good bad games, in the description. The next interesting thing is Desync Studios tried to mod his own drawings in Dust3D. This is exactly why I made this software. I'm really enjoying to watch it. Please check his Twitter link in the description. Next, Eric shared the UV unwrapping library of Dust3D on Twitter. This attracted many people's attention, which including the Goda engine's leader developer, John. He advised to support for text size as input parameter. I have implemented the suggested API and I removed the Qt dependencies. Goda engine currently is using Jonathan's xatlas library to do the UV unwrapping of light map. Is based on a library called the Cara Atlas, which was also used by Dust3D during the early development. About the UV unwrapping, what's being improved? First, I add a UV check talk menu. You can talk the UV to a predefined grid image to see the quality of the unwrapping, and the rotation comparison also being introduced to reduce the final error occupation. And an auto segment algorithm based on the normal value was being implemented. You may see more pieces of UV errands being generated. Okay, next. Toshio made his game mods in Blender many weeks ago. I was trying to reproduce his model in Dust3D. During the progress, there are useful features being introduced. Last week, I tried again the DOM mode using the procedure way. However, it's not the result I was expected, so there will be another try when I got a hand on the improvement of the wrapping algorithm. Thanks, Toshio. I also linked his Twitter in the description. Next, KZ comment on my daily 10 minutes every day mode says, very interesting method of modeling, seems to be very useful to create base mesh for sculpting. I linked the data in the description. Thanks, I guess the next big future of Dust3D is sculpting, or maybe simplified sculpting. I haven't finalized the future. Let's see what will happen in the next couple of weeks. Please leave your comments below if you have any idea on the sculpting future. Okay, this is the week. Please enjoy the full progress of how an eagle head is being made. And don't forget the subscriber and the like button. Thank you all, and see you next time.